Hello Stamper, welcome to Frenchie's video. I'm France Martin, independent demonstrator with Stampin'Up. And today I'm gonna show you a quick and easy to add color to your butterfly tinlets that it's no fussing cutting. I show you a way back with the vellum that, you know, we were tracing it and cutting it. Well, this year it's no fuss, it's quick, boom, it's done, see? And it looked kind of funky coloring. Well, that's what I'm gonna show you. So let's get started. First thing you're gonna need is your Big Shot magneted platform, your clear plate, and my dryer sheet. Can you see there? Here we go. And the dryer sheet, yes, they've been used and used, but it still worked perfectly. Why am I using dryer sheet? You're gonna see in a minute. This here, it is 4 by 5 1/4. Put it down. Put your butterfly the way you want it on your card, the opening. So I'm gonna put that right there. And then another clear sheet on the top. Voila. Now I'm gonna remove this here. See? Boom, nothing stick. It is awesome. And this is the piece of cardstock we're gonna use for the front of the card. And now my butterfly, this is the reason why I like to use dryer sheet, because everything come off, nothing gets stick. If it's a few like this, just rub your finger and it's gone. So it's no fuss of poking those little detail. I showed that maybe a month ago or so. I don't know who came up with the dryer sheet, but let me tell you, it is lovely. Now, before we put that away, we're gonna use, if you look at my butterfly on this one, see, this is glitter paper. This is the Dazzling Diamond glitter paper. Today I'm gonna use the silver, and I'm just gonna cut a little strip. I use all my scrap paper. I mean, I save all my scrap paper of the glitter paper, because a lot of time you just need a bitty piece. Glitter paper need, oops, come back here you. Glitter paper need to face up. Gonna put that right there. And the butterfly, the raised side, face down, and put that right in the center. Now I get that done. We're gonna roll this through. And again, whoops, see, all clean. I absolutely love the dryer sheet. Now, what I'm gonna do with this butterfly, see, I get like funky shape there. So what I'm gonna do, cause I just want the body, I'm gonna just trim it a little bit. Trim those little legs that shouldn't be there. It's no right and wrong, I just go and trim around it. So then I just got the body. Whoops. See, this is funny because this is fussy cutting, I call it, and it's the longest thing to do in this card. So really you can skip this step. It's just that I like the look of this. So voila. Look very funky, but that's going to be my body. Okay, I'm going to put that aside. Before I remove the Big Shot, though, we're going to emboss the frame. I'm going to say this year we're going to emboss this. This one I did the flower in the card that I show you. It is the flower in the occasion catalog. If you see the background, can you see? I think you can see. Oh yeah, here we go. That's the flower. Now I'm gonna use the stripes. So I switch my platform to my regular platform. There, I took the magneted platform away. Clear plate. Now I got the, I want it this way. I got the stylish stripes. Clear plate. My embossing folder with my cardstock in the center, and then another clear plate on top. Okay, let me make some space here. Let's remove this. And now I'm going to show you. Okay, let me bring you down. Hopefully I won't dump the camera like earlier. Here we go. Okay, so I got this, and I wanted to try something different, you see? And I got this one. I thought, well, if we do two cards at the same time, we can, boom. I think that's going to be pretty. So what we're going to do, next step, remember, it's the vellum. What I've done with my vellum, I put this on top. Make sure this is under, this is on top, so I know where to color. Now we're going to use blendability, and it's no right and wrong to color. And the reason why I like blendability, you can use sponge, you can use marker. It's just this color faster. So I'm going to start with, this is Bermuda Bay. This paper was tempting turquoise. So I'm going to just add a bit of color here, bit of color there. Now and a bit in the bottom here. I'm going to use the lighter color. So to be honest with you, I don't have no way right or wrong. I just color mix my color a bit so I get different tone. And the other one, I thought, I had the Melon Mimbo and I had some yellow to it. I absolutely love the look of that. So this one, I'm going to add some Calypso Coral, but I'm going to show you a trick to this. I'm going to start with medium because I don't know which one that's going to look better. You see, my tip want to come out. When that happens, just push it in. So I'm going to add just a little line here and there. Then I'm going to go the other way. Okay, when you're done mixing your color like that, make sure you go like this to wipe the tip. Okay, let's see what this looks when I turn this around. I know it looks funny. Oops. And then, where is my butterfly? Okay, I want very much darker. Can you see? So now, we're going to add some darker. It's not dark enough. Really, I want this side up. So if I want that side up, it needs to face down. And then I put this on top. So now we're going to have some little fixing to do. See? It's okay. I'm going to use Wisteria Wonder, and I'm going to use the dark color. So you just keep on coloring till you get the color that you like. See, I just mix my color, not mix the color, but just really a mess. So then I get different color because you get the butterfly that's going to do the details. So you don't have to worry about that, right? Okay, and now I decide I want some yellow on in that because the first color was very too dark, light. So I'm just going to add some polka dot here and there to add some yellow in my butterfly. See, I have to make sure to wipe it so those colors don't stay on it. So now let's turn this around. That would go this way. Oops, this way. I think that's going to be much better. And then remember I said I'm going to put the black. Perfect. I absolutely love this. So let's glue that. How do you glue that? I just go around the butterfly to make sure it's glued. And then take this. See how funky it is looking? And now I'm going to take this and let's use glue dots. Remember, I'm switching here because I'm doing two cards. So I'm going to put this here. And then I had done, oh, here's my silver. Is my silver gonna go better? Yeah, I'm gonna put my gold on this one and silver on the other one. So again, you can use a Tombow glue too for this, would be working very good. And you know what? I'm gonna need a little shot of Tombow glue right here. Et voila. So now this is it to it, my friends. So if you put it on a color cardstock, let me get one. You're gonna see the difference of the, that's tinting turquoise, but let's say I'm doing yellow in the back. You're gonna see it switch the color quite a bit. So see, it's very dark. So I like to mount it on white because then you see the color much better. See? So now you get your colorful thing. So again, this one here, the black that I had pre-cut for you. So I want this to be in the front. So I would go this way. So what you want in the front, you face it down. It go like, this is my front that I want. So it's gonna face down. Put your vellum paper on top. And then this one, I'm gonna do a lot of yellow and calypso. I think the yellow or rich razzleberry work awesome. So I'm gonna go do all the coat of the Daffodil Delight. It is, I say yellow, but it's Daffodil Delight. And that is the medium one. I'm gonna go with the dark one. And then I'm gonna use Bermuda Bay. No, because my butterfly, it's in the, so let's use, instead of Melon Mimbo, let's try the Rich Razzleberry, the medium color. Because the butterfly is doing the job of the detail. It's just a different color. Okay, let's see what that say. That say blah, right? Let's turn that around. You know what? Let's glue his body right away because that was the silver body we had. Oh, well, if the glue dot would go in the back of it, it would work much better, right? Here we go. Yeah, I got it this time. Here we go. And let's see what that say. Oh, see? Let's use a white cardstock. Et voila, my friend. See, you get all the marble color. So then I'm going to take the Hello You or those tin lids. And I'm going to be able to finish my card. I'm looking for my finished card. And I swear, stuff get, oh, upside down here. So I use the itty bitty punch and the candy dots in the center. And voila, you get an awesome card. And it's quick, really, because I did two here and play with it. So, but I got, see how blah it is in the back? But you don't see that. And it really makes your color in all those little holes. So this is it, how to do the quick and easy vellum color for your cards in the butterfly framelits. And again, I still offer the class in the mail for the butterfly, the basic butterfly. To get all the information on my class in the mail, visit my blog at frenchystamps.com. And for all your Stampin' Up! Product, you can shop 24/7 over there. Thank you so much for your support. Till next time, happy stamping, my friends.